IVM.
Hi.
You're
listening
to
IVM
Daily.
Hello and welcome to IVM Daily. Today I have with me a full house with me and Ashish.
Hello everyone.
And that's all, guys. That's all. That's all that we have.
That's how a Friday looks like
in IVM.
In IVM studios.
So we tried to get a lot of people, but
everybody was just dodging the question.
Yeah, they don't want to talk about this. Yeah. This is very sensitive, according to them.
It's very deep.
So yeah,
it's gonna bring back some bad memories, maybe
some good memories, but
hopefully.
But probably people don't want to revisit those memories.
Because a lot of people just said, you know, I can't. So do you want to introduce the topic to the listeners?
So we'll talk about sports.
Okay. Oh, God.
We'll talk about sports.
Oh, no.
We'll talk about how we used to play and enjoy sports.
Oh, man. That brings back so much.
Yeah. So much. Ashish, what were the games that you used to play during your childhood?
Almost I have played all sports, from baseball to cricket to badminton.
You played baseball?
Yeah, I have. We had a baseball court.
You played baseball in India?
Yeah, I had.
So with a cricket bat or like with a...
No, with a baseball bat. Proper baseball bat. There was like a NRI return kid in our society. So
which society do you stay? No, we have like pretty privileged children in IVM. So Ashish one among them.
So there was no diamond that we played on. It's just one ground, which was our football field. And we went there and we just put four pitches. And then he was explaining to us the rules of the game and everything. And we just played. So it didn't last for more than a month because everybody just got super bored. And then
let's play cricket. Let's play desi baseball.
Desi baseball, yeah. So starting with that, I'm football and badminton and
you are
volleyball.
A football enthusiast.
Yeah,
by the
I am. So that is the only sport that stuck with me for a really long time.
Yeah.
Like I've played all sports, but football is the one that I could resonate the most with. And it stayed and I thought I was, you know, maybe a little bit good at it.
Okay.
Maybe. So I don't know. But
you are never a good judge of your
Exactly. Somebody else should say that.
Yeah. Or somebody should have said, like somebody said that, but I guess Ashish just being modest.
I don't know.
Is there any there were many desi games that we used to play?
Oh yeah. I would love those.
Pittu like, or Seven Stones.
Pittu. I don't know Pittu where it's called, but where I am from we call it Lagori.
Oh, Lagori, yeah. I have heard Lagori, but... Yeah.
So that's where you put seven pieces or like eight pieces of stones, one on top of another, and then with the ball you hit. It's just an excuse to hit your friends really hard with the ball.
So the pleasure that we get throwing a ball on
a friend's face, eyes, aim for the eyes. And
irrespective of the organs, we don't give a shit. So
maybe so many must have just suffering from illnesses just because of the Lagori game.
Still they might be suffering from post... Post-Pittu effects. And what about, have you played Sakli?
Oh man, that was my favorite thing.
Oh
shit.
God.
Oh, that was lovely.
Coco.
That was just a way to grow people.
Ashish has some deep secrets that you should not reveal actually to our listeners.
That's all I'm going to say. And I don't know if you played this game, it was called Dabba I Spice. It was where you get a dabba of some kind.
Okay.
And then you make a circle and then you put a dabba inside it. And there's one person who we have to throw the dabba and he has to get it. And in the time that he gets the dabba to the circle, you have to hide. And then he has to find everybody. And when he finds one person, he puts his one leg on the dabba and he says, "Iska dabba hai spice."
Oh. So
it's like an advanced version of Chupa Chupi.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, like I Spice.
Yeah.
That's not I. Oh, God, that's not I Spice. That's I Spy. Okay.
So, but we just called it I Spice. So, I never got it why it was called I Spice.
Because, India.
India, exactly.
So, were you specialized in any of the sports? Like
Chupa Chupi and all that?
No. Like official games?
No.
Did you specialize in any of the sports?
No, I have never specialized in any of the sports, but I have played football for college.
Okay.
A little bit. And definitely my, the society we used to stay in. So every society, if you know, has their own team.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So they have their own team. The boys of the society, they come together. They have matches against other societies. So I used to play with them.
Okay,
I used to also play in my father's company.
Okay.
Because they had like...
So this was football predominantly?
Properly football.
Yeah.
So I used to play there. And yeah, that's about it. Then after that, I wanted to continue, but I got a serious injury in my knee. So I had to
Every story collapses over there. Every sportsman's story ends over there.
It ends there, yeah.
Same, I remember...
So no. So don't start from the beginning, man. You took all my baseball case, huh?
Okay.
So you have to start from there. Come on. What was early sports you played?
Early sports, I started with cricket.
Okay.
And I was pretty good with my cricketing skills. I was a...
Batsman, bowling, fielding?
I was a batsman.
Oh.
So...
Like an opener?
Not an opener.
Okay.
I used to be an all-rounder, but... Oh. Yeah, so cricketing was later... No. We definitely can't compare any of us with, like, sportsmen. So, yeah.
Okay.
We're, like, society level, school level.
Oh, okay, that way.
Then I remember I got selected for basketball.
Oh.
So I had like...
So direct jump from cricket to basketball.
Yeah. So wow. I have played a lot of games, man. I used to be a sprinter.
Oh.
So yeah.
So you don't sprint?
Now I do sprint, but...
Okay. But as a part of your workout, not like...
Yeah, just as a part of my workout. So I love running. But that's the whole problem. Like once we start working, then I guess.
Then friends don't meet up as they used to, and then the play dates don't happen.
Yeah, so it never happens. Yeah. Like most of my friends are out. Like,
exactly.
So they are abroad and all. So then.
So what were I told you, like, you know, chupa chupi and dabba ice pies, and so any that sport?
Koko.
Oh.
Oh, I just used to love Koko. To play it like Koko and relay.
Relay racing, correct.
And definitely hide and seek.
Hide and seek
is like common.
Like everybody has played. I think even the aliens must have played that game. They must have also, they are playing hide and seek, let's play.
Okay. Oh, God.
That's like the most common sport, I think. Every Indian must have played it once in his life.
Exactly.
At least.
Yeah, then I have definitely played with girls. So, like,
Not
in the other context.
Oh, God.
I have played with girls.
Okay, so
langdi with girls
in like
tip
courts,
like langdi. So I don't play. I'm a good boy. So yeah.
Oh,
I don't.
You're
I don't
a good
play
boy.
With girls. So that was just for the fun element. Because Abbas and Surbi and Janam are missing. So we have to. We have to like brace
our
performance.
Exactly.
Over here.
Exactly. And any sport that you wanted, you wish you could continue, man. Like at least cricket khel leta, ya, you know, at least basketball chal jata thoda.
I would still go for athletics, basically.
Okay.
Basically running.
Oh.
Basketball to some extent,
Mm-hmm.
But after an age, you stop loving basketball because there's nothing like in India at least, there's no way to promote.
Exactly.
I used to be a decent basketball player, but if there was some kind of motivation or like
from your coaches
or something,
exactly,
or from my parents also.
Okay.
So yeah, so I would say a sprinter.
Okay.
A sprinter would be a decent thing that I would have still followed.
Okay.
The sad part of this, the sad question.
So did you meet with some injury of any kind? Like, oh God,
many times. So I used to be a taekwondo player as well.
Okay.
So
that's really wide range.
Yeah. I used to play a lot of games. Guys.
Oh, that's really good. Nowadays, I just see kids playing PUBG on their phone entire day.
Yeah, I seriously...
Or it's like Candy Crush.
I seriously feel bad about the whole concept of mobile gaming being such a boon.
Exactly.
Like, even we used to play games, but...
But not like this,
We used to make out... We used to get
no,
time...
Make out?
Why do you pause my conversation in between and make something else out of it?
Because you take like a really long pause.
Yeah,
okay,
I do take a long...
Continue.
So I forgot what I was saying. So
you were saying about the games part. You were talking about the games. The kids used to play
back in the day we used to play PC games a lot of times. But
Exactly.
We had specific time slots.
Exactly. Exactly.
Like predetermined by our parents. Exactly. So we used to play under those slots. So
we usually stuck to games when there is no friend to play with. And because everybody used to go to, you know, homework, so you used to go to, abhi kya karu, so, you know, play games.
Yeah.
That was like secondary, it was not primary. Nowadays, these games have become primary, and secondary is like, let's meet, you want to play,
if your parents force you into some sports, like
parents have to
join karo, beta wo join karo.
I have seen parents forcing their kids to go play.
Exactly,
like,
I used to wait for that moment, like, shaam 5-6 baje, I used to run out of my house. I used to play for 1 hour, I guess.
I know I used to go to tuition, and from the tuition window I could see my ground.
Okay.
So at the moment 5 o'clock.
What's more distracting than that?
Exactly. So I used to see 5 o'clock, and my friend used to come like, shit man, they are already on the ground and I'm still stuck here.
This happens like, during the exams,
exactly. Yeah. And I was so, like, shit, how do I leave? And then I used to find some stupid excuse every single day to leave at 5 o'clock. My tuition was at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock I moved.
Then came Pokemon at 5 o'clock.
Exactly. Yeah. Then TV took over everything.
Everything, all the fun.
Basically.
And finishing this by asking one question.
Mm-hmm.
What do you follow? Like, is there a diet regime or a fitness regime that you follow just to remain healthy?
Yeah.
Nowadays, this is the present thing that I'm asking.
Yeah, so basically I used to play football a lot.
Yeah.
So those had some dietary restrictions because before the match you could not eat things you can't eat.
Exactly.
So those were there. So once I stopped playing, so those restrictions just came off, and then I used to just eat anything probably. Exactly.
Precisely, yeah.
So then I started seeing changes in my body, you know, I started getting lazy, you know, I couldn't run as fast as I could, and I was like, I used to feel so sad. You know, because you would understand being an athlete, and suddenly you see yourself growing like an adrak from every side. like what the hell, man?
But the worst part being, you enjoyed that phase as well. Like you get to eat everything precisely, and there's no effort that's going outside.
Seriously.
So yeah, you pretty much enjoy that phase as well.
Exactly.
And I'm pretty sure like everyone goes through that phase.
It does. Even when I'm in the gym and my trainer's like, come on, one more, come on. I'm like, arre yaar, kya kar raha hai? I'm like, I tell him straight on the face, ke isse zyada main nahi kar sakta. And I'm just doing this because I can't play football that much. If I would play, I would not have ever seen the face of the gym. It's just because I want to stay healthy.
Yeah.
That's
the only protocol that you have. Like you go to gym.
Exactly. Yeah. Because all I can do is like run, thoda bahut, and swim.
Yeah.
And
okay.
So basic weight training is to just control the, you know, just the body and to
be in a good shape and
that's
be healthy.
That's it. That's the only reason I go to gym. If I were playing sports, bye-bye gym.
Okay.
that is my motto.
Same thing for me. Like gym is so much convenient nowadays, and we have a gym like at every doorstep. So on that note,
yes, I think we should wrap this up because if the sound engineer is going to sleep,
we can estimate like how boring the listeners.
I think okay. So let's wrap this up for today.
So listeners, if you have any suggestion as to like what we should do to maintain our fitness,
or what you do,
we
would love to hear from you.
That's it. And follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram at IVM Podcast. You can follow us you can follow me individually at Grow Up Mohan on Instagram and Twitter, because Ashish is nowhere to be found.
I'm like a ghost.
Yes. We still believe that you are there somewhere.
No, I am not stalking anybody.
You are there somewhere. Maybe you might be in the deep dark web somewhere on the internet. Okay, so bye guys.
Bye for today. Signing off. Bye bye.
Hi. My name is Abbas. I'm a producer at IVM. And I, along with other staff members of IVM, we do this show called IVM Likes, where we give recommendations of books, movies, music, TV shows that we've seen. We've even recommended video games and YouTube channels. And we are soon reaching our 100th episode. We are on episode 99 right now. And on the 100th episode, we'd love to hear from you. So send us your messages, voice notes, goodwill, all of it on shows@indusvox.com, and we will read out your messages on the 100th episode of IVM Likes. Tell us about the recommendations we've given you that you've enjoyed. Tell us about the episodes that you remember. Tell us about the conversations that you've enjoyed, and we will read all of it out on the 100th episode. Send your messages on shows@indusvox.com, and do tune into the 100th episode of IVM Likes out next week.
Advertising is dead. Yep, you heard me right. Advertising is dead. We're all in the content business now. Let's not call it news, TV, radio, etc., etc. It's all content, and we're in the middle of this weirdly exciting phase where all the borders and lines that have been drawn over decades has been swept away by this lovely thing called the internet. We're a show where we don't dwell on just the stuff that is now, but rather the wider stuff about advertising, media, content, and the whole goddamn circus surrounding it. Tune in every Tuesday for our weekly unboxing of the mystery box we used to call advertising. I'm Varun Dugirala, co-founder and content chief at The Glitch, and this is my new podcast, Advertising is Dead.